seemed to be royalty, but had a head the size of a pumpkin.
It must have been really something.
You made it. Huh? Follow me. Now, like I said in my letter, we are going into business. I've been breaking down animals since I was knee-high to a splinter. And I worked as a tanner up in Wisconsin back in the
60s. It's a very long story.
So I've got three words for you. Cripps Trading Company. Pristine pelts and animal parts for bulk sale. I know the market's there. All I need is a partner. So I'm thinking you source the materials. Skins, plumes, horns, and the like. I'll clean them and prep them. Then you go out and make the sale. Hell, we might even eat well out of this for once, too. Wouldn't that be nice? Why are you still here with us?
Your provisions, Mr. Cripps.
Oh, yeah. Pack the rest on there, will you? Now, with any opportunity comes risk. Competitors, thieves, me losing interest in the whole idea. But if we combine our talents, we'll be unstoppable. Now, I will require an initial modest investment, of course, startup costs and such like, but you'll recoup that as fast as you can say, "Hey, Cripps, you handsome genius." So how about it? Are you in? Oh, I forgot. Not much in the coffers right now, is there? No problem to pay me later. You know where to find me.
Hello. You must be new to town. I have an assortment of hunting bait and tools, if you haven't noticed. Worms and crickets by the front door, and don't miss the scent blocker by the back window.
Keep it settled down, okay? All right, then. Life is too short for this kind of trouble. Good. Guess you remember how to behave.
Hope you're ready to die in this.
Guess you remember how to behave.
Venison, all right here, folks. Good to see you back. Not to worry. I'll be back.
That piece on display?